So as bones grow, the cells that are growing inside the bone are FGFR3 positive cells. What this means, if we zoomed in really close, is that these cells in red here, if we looked very close up, here's the cell membrane. This red protein here is the FGFR3 protein. We have two proteins right here, and they're embedded in the membrane. As you can imagine, proteins in the membrane are important because they're what communicate from the outside world to the inside world. Now, if there are actually two FGFR3 proteins like this, they're considered inactive. Nothing is happening. Because the only way the FGFR3 protein can do anything is if it's bound to its favorite partner protein, FGF3. The R in FGFR3 stands for a receptor because it receives the signal from FGF3. It's like it's serving as a docking platform. So these two FGFR3 proteins can get close together. And once they're close together, then there's a signal that's sent to slow down bone growth. So normally these cells in red that are FGFR3 positive are growing and dividing and contributing to the cells in the long bone, helping it grow longer. But there's a signal that comes from the environment that is transmitted through the FGFR3 protein, so that whenever the FGF3 protein is around, it's a signal that says, whoa, slow down, guys, slow down your bone growth. Now, what happens in the case of the G1138A mutation, the missense mutation, is that right here in this region where the protein spans across the cell membrane, that's where the amino acid change has happened. And now this FGFR3 protein doesn't have to wait for FGF3. It can form this pair, what we call a dimerization, dimer, di meaning two here, even when there's no protein partner to facilitate the interaction, right? We don't see that yellow protein here connecting the two FGFR3s. So this means we're going to slow down bone growth like we normally would, but now it's going to happen even when the FGF3 isn't around. So the net effect are bones that grow shorter than they normally would because the FGFR3 protein is going to be slowing bone growth down even when the FGF3 isn't around. It means that this protein is sort of always on now. Overall, this results in a form of short limb dwarfism called achondroplasia. If you want to know where the name comes from, a chondrocyte is what we call a bone cell, a chondrocyte. So the chondro part is what we're referring to as bone here. Plasia means growth, so chondroplasia means bone growth, and achondroplasia means the absence or the loss of, so the loss of bone growth. And that's what dwarfism is in this sense. A person with achondroplasia will have shorter limbs and overall be a shorter person with a distinctive facial structure, also due to altered bone development of the skull. So would you categorize this allele here, the G1138A allele, as a loss of function, a gain of function, or no change in function allele?